We all descend from somebody that made a difference, perhaps may have given of their lives just so that some of us even have a right to sit in a classroom.
And the way that people have contributed to this country absolutely needs to be part of our whole country's narrative.
When I used to feel challenged, I would just think about my ancestors. And I said, my goodness, if they could make these accomplishments with all of the challenges that they endured, certainly whatever I'm experiencing is nothing in comparison.
We stand on the shoulders and we walk in the shoes of those that came before us. I am the great-great-great-grandson of Frederick Douglass, and I'm also the great-great-grandson of Booker T. Washington. Even with all of those greats, I can say that I stand one person away from history, and I stand one person away from slavery.
Ida B. Wells is my great-grandmother. She decided to use her voice as a journalist in order to expose these atrocities that were happening to the Black community during Reconstruction and afterwards.
I am the third daughter of six of Malcolm X and Dr. Betty Shabazz. My father provided the biggest critique of America with his insistence that America live up to her promise of liberty and justice for all. I was so young when he was assassinated. You know, I remembered really vividly his smile.
You know, Frederick Douglass at the age of 20 made the decision that he was going to step on a train and ride away from slavery. That was a decision that he was making for himself, but it was also a decision that he was making for his descendants, for me.
Our ancestors did not have opportunities to live out some of their dreams, and so they put their dreams into their children and their grandchildren.
I believe that we're all still fighting the same fight that my ancestors fought. Unfortunately, there's still so much work to be done. In 2005, when I read a National Geographic magazine, and the cover story was 21st century slaves, and it was about human trafficking and modern day slavery existing all over the world in every country, including right here in the United States, I understood that I had this platform that my ancestors had built through struggle and through sacrifice, and perhaps we could leverage the historical significance of my ancestry to do something about this issue.
People were like, oh my God, you're Malcolm X's daughter, and it was overwhelming. And I remember my elder sister saying, you don't have to pass a test to be Malcolm's daughter, you already are. You know, so when I think of my father as just a young man, he did this work out of the goodness of his heart. And this false image that was made of him was so inaccurate. And it is the reason why I set out to do my books.
What drives me is I feel a strong need for this country to recognize the contributions of women and the contributions of people of color to this country in the positive ways. I mean, our stories are very undertold. I think it's important for people to know the past in order to have an understanding of the present and the future.
I don't believe that we can start to have conversations about healing and reconciliation until we have conversations about truth-telling, what really happened in this country.
The omission of Black, Indigenous, Brown, Asian, and Latin history is not accidental. These kinds of exclusions distance people from their own heritage and ultimately their own sense of self. It is now our opportunity to address these injustices, these systemic injustices.
My father said it would be this young generation who would recognize that those in power have misused it and demand change, and that they would be willing to roll up their sleeves and do the necessary work to ensure, you know, this change.
What I've seen in the past year leaves me hopeful, because I saw people of all races and all ages out there protesting all over this country and around the world for Black Lives Matter.
We did the best we could with what we had to work with. We took advantage of opportunities that were available during our lifetime and tried to make the world a better place so that the next generation could have even more opportunity, freedom, justice, and equality.
When we look back at all the great people that came before us, I don't believe that they were thinking about having their names on buildings or their likenesses on statues. They just rolled up their sleeves and just did the work that needed to be done.
Hi everyone, George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.